Hello students, hope you all would be fine. Today we will be discussing about types of phrases. We had already discussed what is a phrase. What is a sentence? We had discussed that sentence is a group of words which makes a complete sense. It starts with a capital letter and it ends with a full stop or a question mark or exclamatory mark. It is a group of words. It makes complete sense. It starts with a capital letter and it ends with a question mark or a capital or a full stop or exclamation mark. It has a subject and a verb. These were the conditions for any group of words for that we can say that it is a sentence. Then again we discussed what is a phrase. Then we came to know that phrase is also a group of words. Phrase is also a group of words which doesn't make complete sense, but it makes some sense. Sentence was also a group of words, means so many sentence words we used to bring closer and it gave complete sense. And phrase also, it is a group of words, but it does not give complete sense. Phrase always gives some sense. It will always give some sense. It will never give complete sense. It will never have subject and a verb. In sentence, there is a subject of verb. Subject and verb. Sentence always gives complete meaning. But phrase doesn't have subject and verb. And it doesn't give complete meaning. Only it gives some meaning. Only the similarity is that the sentence is also a group of word. And phrase is also a group of word. Suppose that if I say, instead of reminding him, he did not complete his work. So instead of is a group of word, it is a phrase. The boy in the pink shirt is my friend. In the pink shirt, it is a group of words and it is a part of the sentence. We are not getting its complete meaning. In the pink shirt, some meaning we are getting, but we are not getting its complete meaning. That is why in the pink shirt is the phrase. So that is why phrase is always a group of words, but it will not give complete meaning. It will give some meaning and it will not have the subject and verb. Now, how many types of phrases are there? There are three types of phrases: noun phrase, adverb phrase and adjective phrase. So phrase is a part of sentence. Phrase doesn't stand alone. Always we will find that phrase is coming between the sentence. Means somewhere in the sentence it will be there. It is a part of sentence. So anybody has asked you that you identify which part of the sentence is phrase here. You identify the phrase. Phrase is where in this sentence, if somebody is asking. You identify and also tell its kind. Which kind of phrase is this? So first of all, while identifying the phrase, we will have to take care of two things in our mind. Our concepts are clear, then nobody will defeat us in phrase. First is, we should be able to identify that group of words. That it is a group of words and it is not giving complete sense and it doesn't have a subject and a verb. We have to identify that part. Suppose that if I say he wanted to learn Sanskrit. Now you see here, to learn is the group of words, means two words are coming here. So to learn is a group of words. It is giving some meaning, but it is not giving complete meaning. So that is why to learn is the phrase. And what is a noun phrase? Noun phrase is a group of words which acts as a noun. So to learn, when we are hearing to learn, when we are seeing this word to learn, we are feeling that it is learning given here, then it is not a noun, it is a verb. No, it is not a verb, it is a noun. To learn is a noun. How to learn is a noun? Because we are thinking that learning is a verb, but no, it is not there that he is learning. He is wanting. The action is not learning, but action is wanting. To learn is a thought. To learn is a type of thought. That is why it is a thought, and that is why it is a noun. We can say it is an abstract noun, to learn. And most of the times while we are finding, when we have to find out the noun phrase is the easiest phrase out of all of the three things. Noun phrase is the easiest one. Most of the times when we have to find out the noun phrase, it always starts with a to, T-O-2 or ing. Suppose that if I say, his hobby is making sketches. Now you see here, making sketches. Now you will be thinking, sir, making is a verb. But no, the action is. Means it is a general fact. Making sketches is a thought. It is an action, but this action is actually not being performed. His hobby is that he is making sketches. So making sketches. Suppose that if I say smoking is injurious to health. So smoking, SMOKING, there smoking is injurious to health. Smoking is not acting as a verb there. Smoking, although we are finding that we are thinking that smoking is an action, but no, smoking is injurious to health. If I am saying so, smoking is a thought that is smoking. It is not the action. It is the thing that I am telling you about. So there, smoking is a noun. So here also, making sketches. We don't think that it is a verb, but it is a noun. To learn, it is not a verb, but it is a noun, and it is a group of words. It is also a group of words. That is why it is a noun phrase. So while identifying the noun phrase, we have to find out whether it should start with a to or ing, and it should act as a noun. So it is acting as a noun, to learn, making sketches. It should be acting as a noun, and most of the times it will start with to or ing. It is the basic formula. While noun phrase I am telling you about, most of the time, I can think most of the time, 90% you can see, to learn or ing it starts with, then it will be noun phrase. Second is adverb phrase. What is an adverb phrase? Adverb phrase always acts as an adverb. I have told you. Now, what is an adverb? Now you will say, sir, acts as an adverb, but what is an adverb? So first of all, you should know what is an adverb. Adverb is a word which qualifies a noun or a pronoun. Adverb is a word which tells something about a noun or a pronoun. No, sorry. Adverb is a verb which tells something about verb. Adverb is a word which tells something about verb. It qualifies the verb. It qualifies the verb means action. So adverb always qualifies the action. Adverb always qualifies the action. So the group of words which is acting as a phrase, it should not have a subject and a verb. Phrase doesn't have a subject and a verb. Either it is noun phrase or adverb phrase or adjective phrase. It will not have a subject and a verb. It will be a group of word and it will give some meaning but not give complete meaning. Any phrase it will be there. It will be always, it will be a group of words. It will give some meaning. It will not give complete meaning. And there will not be subject and verb. So, but adverb phrase if we are talking about, so that phrase which is describing something more about verb, which is telling the quality of the verb, how the verb is being performed, how the action is being performed. Suppose that if I say, I looked for the pen at every possible place. Now which is the group of word which is giving some sense but not giving complete sense? At every possible place. It is a group of words. It is giving some sense. At every possible place I am getting some meaning, na? But not complete meaning. At every possible place. Some meaning I am getting but not complete meaning. So at every possible place, some meaning we got. And it is not having subject and a verb. At every possible place there is no subject and verb. So that is why it is a phrase. Now which type of phrase is that? Now we have to identify at every possible place. For which thing it is being told? At every possible place. किस चीज के लिए आया है? देखने के लिए आया है कि हमने देखा कहां देखा? एट एवरी पॉसिबल प्लेस. सो लुक्ड इज द एक्शन. इट इज क्वालिफाइंग. एट एवरी पॉसिबल प्लेस इज क्वालिफाइंग लुक्ड एंड लुक्ड इज द वर्ब. सो द वर्ड विच क्वालिफाइज अ वर्ब इज एडवर्ब. सो एट एवरी पॉसिबल प्लेस इज एक्टिंग एज एन एडवर्ब. एट एवरी पॉसिबल प्लेस बिकॉज इट इज कमिंग फॉर द वर्ड लुक्ड and look, this is a verb. So at every possible place is qualifying the verb. That is why at every possible place is adverb, isn't it? Now the second question, the second sentence we see. The car moved at great speed. The car moved at great speed. So which is the word? You can identify now. At great speed. At great speed, because it is a group of words. It is giving some sense. It is not giving complete sense. It does not have a subject. It does not have a verb. That is why this is a phrase. This is a part of sentence at great speed. Now you can identify, sir, which type of phrase is this? It is a noun phrase. No, I have told you, but always noun phrase, most of the times it starts with to or ing, so there is no to or ing. Now it can be adverb or adjective. So now you can see, sir, it is great written here, great speed, so that is why it is an adjective phrase. Great means it is coming about speed, and it is a type of it is qualifying something about noun. No, you don't think that great is acting as an adjective. It is telling about speed. No, at great speed is the whole of the phrase, and it is coming about what? At great speed किसके लिए आया है? Move करने की तरीके को बता रहा. Moved. How did the car move? The car moved at great speed. So at great speed, you don't get confused. First of all, while identifying the phrase, we have to see noun phrase. No, but in adverb phrase and in adjective phrase, we have always to see that the phrase is qualifying which thing. If the phrase is qualifying the verb, then it is adverb phrase. And the phrase is qualifying a noun or a pronoun, then it is adjective phrase. Phrase agar verb ko qualify kar raha, to wo adverb phrase hai. Agar phrase noun ya pronoun ko qualify karta hai, then it is an adjective phrase. Bahut clear hona chahiye. Noun phrase to pata hai, to aur ing se shuru ho sakta hai. But adverb and adjective phrase, we have to be very careful ki wo jo group of words hai, what we are telling it as a phrase, it is qualifying which thing. If the phrase is qualifying a noun or a pronoun, then it is adjective phrase. And if the phrase is qualifying a verb, then it is adverb phrase. Suppose that at great speed, so we are thinking that it is an adjective, but this is not an adjective. It is qualifying about moving. How the car was moving? The car was moving at great speed. So at great speed is the adverb here. It is not the adjective. I looked for the pen at every possible place. At every possible place, it is a group of words, and it is telling about what? At every possible place. About looking, how it was looked, where it was looked, at every possible place. And looking is a verb, moved is a verb, and that is why at every possible place has come for verb. That is, it is adverb phrase. At great speed, it is coming about verb. That is why at great speed is a adverb phrase. So noun phrase here, I think you will know to and ing. But in adverb phrase and adjective phrase, so first of all we will identify the phrase, and then we will see that it is qualifying which thing. If it is qualifying a verb, then it is adverb phrase, and if it is qualifying noun or a pronoun, then it is adjective phrase. Then we will see adjective phrase. What is adjective phrase? The girl in pink dress is known to me. Now you see, the girl in pink dress, isn't it? In pink dress. So in pink dress is a group of words. It is a group of words, in pink dress, isn't it? It is a group of words. It is a part of the whole of the sentence. It is giving some sense. In pink dress, some sense we are getting, but not the complete sense. We are getting some sense. We are not. It is not giving the complete sense. It doesn't have in pink dress. No subject, no verb. That is why it is a phrase. Now, in pink dress, किसके लिए आया है? Which word it is qualifying? क्या ये action को qualify कर रहा है? Action is known. क्या ये known के लिए आया है? No. In pink dress किसके लिए आया है? Girl के लिए आया है. In pink dress is qualifying the word girl, and girl is a noun, common noun. So that is why in pink dress is a phrase which is qualifying a noun. That is why it is an adjective phrase. Very clear. Because it is the group of words which is acting as a phrase, it is qualifying a noun or a pronoun. That is why it is adjective phrase. Here girl is a noun, and that is why in pink dress will be adjective phrase. Next sentence you see, the fruits from our garden are fresh and tasty. Now you see here, fresh and tasty, it's a group of word. It is the part of whole of the sentence. It has no subject, it has no verb and it is a acting as a phrase. Now fresh and tasty किसके लिए आया है? Fruits के लिए आया है. क्या चीज fresh and tasty है? Fruits, and fruits is a noun. So that is why fresh and tasty is qualifying a noun and that is why it is an adjective phrase. So while identifying about adverb phrase and adjective phrase, we have to be very careful that the phrase is qualifying which thing. If the phrase is qualifying a verb, then it is adverb phrase. At great speed means move. At every possible place, it has come for look. So if it has come for verb, then it is adverb phrase. And if it has come for a noun or a pronoun, so that is adjective phrase. So hope you understand. If there is any problem, you can discuss. Thanks for watching and have a wonderful day.